Hi, this is Apex IPSA CEO, Dr. Joe Leader. Today, I'm here with Intelsat Senior Vice President of Commercial, Dave Bajor. Dave, thanks so much for taking the time today.
Good to see you.
So for Intelsat, let me ask the hard question first. What genuinely differentiates you now in a very, very developed connectivity marketplace? What are you doing differently for your airlines and for their customers?
I think the show has got a lot of connectivity companies, all of which have great products and services. And I think what's separating us, what's making us different, is that we have two very modern, great antenna systems that go on airplanes. We've been selling 2KU for a number of years. It's a mechanically steered phased array antenna system, which is great. It's super high reliability, delivered by ThinkCom. It's a great industry-leading antenna. But one of the realities of what's going on in aviation right now is that the airlines want to get to a point where they are carbon neutral, where they achieve the goal by 2050 that's been set for them, that they all are part of. And part of that is reducing the weight and the fuel and the drag and thereby the emissions that come from the aircraft when we put these antennas on the airplane. So what we've done over the last year is start developing an electronically steered array. This is a smaller antenna, goes on top of the aircraft. It's got a unique capability in that it can communicate with both GEO and LEO satellites. So there's a partnership with OneWeb there, which we can talk more about. But the key thing about this is that this new antenna weighs about 60% less than our 2KU antenna. That's meeting the goal that the airlines have. So I think the differentiation point for us is having two antenna choices, which creates more flexibility for customers. And I think flexibility is the name of the game.
I agree with you that flexibility is the name of the game. And let's talk about a new added card in your deck of flexibility, your relationship with OneWeb. How is that going to integrate in, and what advantage is that going to give Intelsat moving forward?
I think the partnership with OneWeb puts us in a position to take advantage of the best of both. So our geostationary network, which is comprised of 52 satellites flying around the planet, offers redundant coverage, particularly at hub cities where it's most important, most valued. But those are not capable of delivering polar coverage. One of the benefits that LEO services can bring to us is covering the poles. And so when we think about wide-body aircraft that fly, let's say, from the United States to Asia, many of them go over the North Pole. Well, the combination of the GEO and LEO network offers us global coverage. So for a flight that's going from the East Coast of the United States to Asia, for example, we can now use the GEO network for certain parts of that flight and the LEO network for certain parts of that flight. And I think that's an exciting point of differentiation for us.
Well, speaking of points of differentiation, Dave, tell me about where Intelsat is going with its own satellites. What's going to be changing in the upcoming year or so?
So we are in the process of launching a whole fleet of new satellites. These are called software-defined satellites. And we will start launching those in 24 and 25. And that fleet, two of them coming from Airbus and two from Thales, are going to be absolutely game changers for us. Huge KU band, high throughput satellites that we call software defined satellites. And that technology is going to ride on top of what we already have today, which is a whole network of wide beam and high throughput satellites. We will launch a new satellite called IS-40E in the early part of next year. That'll serve the Americas in particular. So we've got now a $2 billion roadmap to launch new satellites and more capacity for customers, which is what they want.
That's great. Speaking about new customers and the future, let's turn to what Apex Expo really does well, which is the future of the travel experience. What do you see 5 years out now? What is it going to be like for your airlines and their customers?
I think the future for our airline partners is definitely a entertainment-centric one. And what I mean by that is increasingly, customers are getting on airplanes with their own content license, whether it's Hulu or Netflix or whatever the case may be. And we want to make sure that customers can use those subscriptions. So I think there's going to be a new generation of content that gets on the airplanes wirelessly without physical media loads and gives customers and passengers the opportunity to watch the content they want rather than just the content that the airline selected for them.
That's really well put. And one of the things as covered yesterday by the Hollywood Reporter, which showed the overall market for content being a $250 to $300 million business. One of the areas highlighted is how customers, because they're being introduced to new content, new series, they're being roped in to streaming services on the ground. Do you think that will be a growing part of the portfolio play, having that the newly allowed, via what we're setting up here, via Apex and its partners, newly allowed beam down once, cache during flight, transmit in addition to what the airlines are putting on their hard drives?
I think that's a really nice use case, and one that I think will come to life within the 5-year time horizon that you mentioned. There are some issues with secure websites and the way the content's cached on the airplane. So we've got some experiments that we've conducted in this area. But ultimately, what passengers want to view is going to be controlled by passengers. And our job is simply to enable that. I feel really good about that. I feel good about the technology stack we're putting on airplanes from a server and hardware and WAPS perspective to enable this future. Airlines don't want to change hardware on airplanes very often. So our goal is to try to look ahead and plan now for what we anticipate those needs are going to be, what we anticipate the passenger demand is going to look like for content, and put the right hardware on the airplane now.
That's really well said, and I like how it all ties together, because ultimately, when I go on board an aircraft, I don't want to just see what I see for my streaming services. I love the new content, but I love being able to have the best of both worlds. So I can have something that I might be finishing from the ground while I'm experiencing something new in the
Flexibility
air.
Flexibility is a big part of it, Joe. I mean, I think that's what airlines are asking us for every day. Flexibility in antenna choice, flexibility in network that the airplane can connect to, flexibility in entertainment options like you and I just discussed. I think that's the name of the game.
That's great, Dave. Well, congratulations on all the great work that you're doing for Intelsat, and thank you for taking the time today.
Thanks a lot, Joe.